this from mensuration, two mutually perpendicular chords AB and CD meet at a point P inside the circle such that AP is 6 centimeters, PB is 4 units, and DP is 3 units. 6, 4, and 3 units. What is the area of the circle? AP is 6, PB is 4, DP is 3, and they are perpendicular to each other. Let's draw the diagram. Two chords that are perpendicular to each other. This is 90 degrees. This is 8 and 3. This is 6. To start with, what will be PB? Product of the chords, two product of the rectangles formed by two intersecting chords is equal, or CP into PD equals AP into PB. 8 into 3 equals AP into PB, or 24 equals 6 into PB. PB is 4. It should be 4 units. Still need to find area of the circle, or we need to find the radius. Now the method is clear. From here, draw a perpendicular here, and I draw a perpendicular here. Why are we drawing this? From the center of a circle, if you draw a line perpendicular to a chord, that will bisect the chord. So we can find the points where the center of the circle meets the foot of the perpendicular. Once we have that, we should be able to use Pythagoras theorem in some form or stripe and then simplify this question. Right? We go to the diagram. We draw ON and OM. Now this AM will be half of AB. This is 5. Or MP, this is 1. Now CN is half of 11. So this CN is 5.5. The whole thing is 8, or NP is 2.5. ON is 1, OM is 2.5. We have found the dimensions of this rectangle. We still need to find the radius. We can do it by two methods, either join AO or join OC. A circle, if you draw a line square equals ON square plus CN square equals 1 square plus 5.5 whole square. Or this side, we can say OA square equals OM square plus 5 square, AM square, which is 2.5 square plus 5 square. 6.25 plus 25, which is 31.25. Or 1 plus 30.25, which is 31.25. Or R square equals 31.25. We need to find area of the circle, which is pi R square, which is pi into 31.25. Or pi into pi by 4, the 31.25 into 4, just trying to write it like a fraction. 31.25 into 2 is 62.5, becomes 125. So 125 pi by 4. Just simple idea. The two properties are important. One is Pythagoras theorem. We'll keep using that over and over again. Second property, from the center of a circle, if you draw a line perpendicular to a chord, it'll bisect the chord. From center of a circle, if you draw a line to midpoint of the chord, it'll be perpendicular to the chord. These lines OM and ON, if I mean for it to be perpendicular, it'll happen to bisect it. If I draw it to the midpoint, it'll happen to be perpendicular. That one property is going to be the bedrock for a number of questions on geometry, especially with circles, so keep that in mind.